Please note, this show contains adult language and themes, and is intended for mature audiences only. Listener discretion is advised.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to get through this thing called life.
Hello. Thank you. My name is Jimmy Gonzalez, and this is the Reset Yourself 22 podcast. As she said, episode 137. Let me begin again by always saying how grateful I am for the many of you that write in and let me know that you are listening, and how much this show means to you as much as it means to me. And for that, I'm very grateful. And I appreciate the time that you put in, because I know time is valuable. And I know a lot of you have crazy schedules and you're able to fit the show in between here and there. So thank you. So let us begin with today's show is about your voice and the many aspects of it. By the time we're done, you're going to have a lot of information to think about when it comes to using your voice. So let us begin with understanding that your voice is not just for the physical act of speaking, but it is also about the ability to influence, connect, and inspire. Here is a closer look at the impact your voice can make. The way you can use your voice can shape opinions and drive actions. How about the power of your voice simply by the tone, the cadence? And you know that you can persuade others and convey authority and make so many compelling arguments. Think of all the speeches that you have heard throughout your life. History is full of leaders and orators whose speeches changed the course of events. From Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream to Winston Churchill's wartime addresses. As a lover of history, from JFK to Lincoln, some of the most amazing, inspirational speeches. Now, you may think that I am actually comparing you and your voice to one of them. I mean, they were amazing. Well, I think you are too. And I am comparing them to you. I know you have so much to say, even if you don't know you do. Now, maybe it is not a powerful speech that you have to share like one of them to the masses, but possibly speaking your piece with a friend, with a loved one, with your children. Your voice is a few words and you can share with someone, can save someone's life. But if you've never allowed yourself to speak, I can only imagine the loss to others, to friends, and to families by not hearing you. You are so powerful, and sadly, many of you don't know it. Someone once said, life without liberty is like a body without spirit. So how are you feeling spiritually? Do you feel that you have the freedom to pray to whom you wish right now without judgment from friends or family? Something so many of us take for granted, freedom of religion. You see, I am blessed that I was able to worship in my home without judgment from my parents and in my relationships. You never realize how lucky you are with the many freedoms you have until they are no longer there. Are you free in your home to pray, to play, and to just be without fear of being judged from others? Keeping your freedom is a multifaceted endeavor, blending personal autonomy with responsibility and awareness. It's about maintaining the ability to make choices that align with your values while respecting others, right to do the same. Do you know your values, your goals, and your boundaries? Self-awareness helps you make decisions that reflect your true self, rather than conforming to external pressures or expectations, you know, boundaries. That is such a topic, especially with clients. Having boundaries from a very young age is how you are able to lay out how you should be able to be treated. But we tend to lower them quite a bit, to the point that others can now cross over our boundaries without any clue of what can be said or not said. When you live without boundaries, it is very difficult to live a life free to do what you want and say, because those around you do not know where your beliefs start or end. Using your voice is a fundamental way to discover and share your identity. Your expression through speaking or writing helps you articulate your thoughts, your feelings, and your values. And I will get into that in a little bit. When you express yourself, you clarify your beliefs, your desires, and your goals. This process, speaking, helps in understanding who you are and what you stand for. Do you journal? I'm not saying to become a published author, but just for yourself. It's something that I've always recommended to all of my clients, to journal. Journaling or engaging in conversation about personal experiences can reveal so much about yourself while you're writing. Good example is this podcast right here, what you're listening to. A big part of the reason I do it is because it helps me. As I think about topics and write page after page, I hear myself think. I'm journaling. And I really get to learn about, well, so many things. And most of all, I learn a lot about myself. Isn't this one of our main goals in life? To learn and to better ourselves? So as I do every week, talking out loud, or if you choose to speak to a therapist, expressing your emotions verbally can be very, very therapeutic. Speaking about your feelings, whether to a friend, family member, therapist, even your mirror, can alleviate stress and provide clarity. Bottling up emotions can lead to increased anxiety and depression. It may feel like it works, but it doesn't. Whereas vocalizing these thoughts can lead to emotional release and healing. By articulating what you feel, you create space for empathy and support from others, which is crucial for mental well-being. Like many of you, have decided to keep it in and bottle it up. But sometimes it seems easier to do, but your mind and body can, bottle up only so much before you fill it to the brim and pop like the weasel. Effective communication is the foundation of healthy relationships. Using your voice to express your needs, your desires, and boundaries creates understanding and connection with others. This is why so many marriages and relationships end. Lack of communication. When you stop talking to each other and saying what you want and what you don't want, you're better off just ending it. This allows for powerful interactions and will build trust if you talk. Know that expressing appreciation or concerns directly can strengthen bonds and resolve most conflicts. Think of all the social movements that have relied on powerful voices to drive change. Speaking out against inequality, discrimination, and other issues can mobilize communities and affect change. Your voice, whether through activism, writing, or public speaking, can contribute to larger movements and influence public opinion. Yes, you can. The power of one, the power of you, the power you have to speak your mind. And there are many different ways to speak up. Soon you will be asked to go to your polls and vote. What a way to speak up and let government know how you feel. So active participation in civil life often requires using your voice. Voting and attending town hall meetings can be very impactful. Ways to make your opinion heard. By voicing your concerns and preferences, you contribute to the democratic process. Although you may not believe it, your vote can influence policy decisions. How about communication at work? There are those of you that prefer to keep it all in, especially at work. Understand in professional settings, effective communication is key to career growth. If you're at work and you want something, say it. If you feel that you can't, it's time to go. And it is that easy. Your ability to articulate ideas clearly and persuasively can impact job performance, networking opportunities, and leadership roles. For example, presenting a well-structured argument or delivering a compelling presentation can showcase your expertise and influence decision makers. Mastering communication skills can lead you to career advancement and to open so many new doors, so many new opportunities. Sadly, I have known many people in many of my jobs that I felt were very qualified, some more than me. But these coworkers were those that chose to just be satisfied with getting a check and going on day by day, which is totally fine. But see how by not using your voice and not speaking your piece limits you from a better position and the possibility of more money. It would be very difficult to be a leader and lead your staff and not being able to speak. A good leader relies on their voice to inspire and guide others. Well, a good leader. A good leader inspires vision, motivates teams, and fosters a positive work environment. And why creating a team of business can only succeed. But please note, talk is cheap. If you don't take as much time to listen, it doesn't matter. You must be good at listening and be engaging by using your voice to share your goals and values with that power behind it all. You can create so much success and build strong, motivated teams at work. As I write this, I can't help but think of and be inspired by amazing voices like Maya Angelou. She was a poet and an activist who used her voice in support of the civil rights movement. How about, and this is going to be funny, Ashton Kutcher. Yes, Ashton Kutcher. He did Punk'd, but he became more than an actor. He used his fame and his voice with partner Demi Moore to create Thorn, an organization that works with tech companies and law enforcement to prevent child sex trafficking. Kutcher has also given presentations on Capitol Hill about Thorn's progress and what changes the government can make. You see, he used his voice. That is a great use of power. Speaking of using your voice and using it, do you think that you have a good voice? Maybe a radio voice for podcasts, or maybe as a job, like as an audiobook narrator. I personally may look into it, something I've always been interested in, but as for using your voice on social media, and I don't mean recorded, I mean sharing your expression. This tends to be the opposite for people that are usually quiet and shy when it comes to a face-to-face conversation. Besides bringing people closer, social media has magically given a lot of people the biggest set of balls in the world. I'm always amazed at how outspoken people are when their words, where these words come from, behind the screen of a computer, sitting from home in the safety, where they can say anything they wish. And you know what they say about opinions? Opinions are like assholes. Everyone has one. And on social media, they do. And I am always amazed at the idea of backing your facts and not forcing your beliefs on others goes out the window on social media. So this is when I will have to remind you that what you post varies, but pretty much stays on the internet for quite some time. depending on which platform. So yes, it is wonderful. Your voice can now be reached by a global audience, which has helped me tremendously. This podcast, last I checked, is being played in over 65 countries, which would have been very difficult pre-social media. So on a business level, it is amazing. On a personal level, it is a power that if it falls in the wrong hands, well, you've probably witnessed people taking advantage of social media. Social media has amplified the power of the individual voices, allowing people to share anything, to begin movements, and influence the public. And of course, people will believe anything they read because if it's posted, it must be true, like the weather and the news. Misuse of social media can spread misinformation and exacerbate conflicts, highlighting the need for thoughtful and ethical communication. Your online presence is an extension of your voice. Everything you post, everything you comment. The way you express yourself through blogs, social media, and other digital platforms contributes to your online identity. So, managing this digital footprint is very crucial, as it can affect your personal and professional reputation. Being mindful of how you use your voice online helps in maintaining a positive and authentic digital presence. Side note, remember, even when you go to a job, your bosses have full right to go through your social media and see who you really are. More than, I've actually spoken to bosses that say that they'll look at that first before they look at your resume. Here's a question. Do you maybe not talk because you may feel judged? Many people do have issues with being judged. Overcome these obstacles involves building confidence and recognizing the value of your perspective. In some cultures or social contexts, expressing oneself openly can be challenging, I understand, to the norms or expectations. I get it. Navigating these constraints requires sensitivity and adaptability. It's not easy, and I understand. So if you're one to like not speak too much, I understand. But understand you also don't get your way. And here's another tip. You don't get your way by being an asshole or by being rude or by being snotty or as some people think, I'm just being tough. No, it comes across that you're being a dick. You use honey. Honey always. Never, ever vinegar. Yet, most of us give little consideration to the potential power of our voices. We don't understand how important it is. If you're like most people, you might only consider your voice when you hear a recording of yourself. How many of us have done that and hate how it sounds? Surprisingly, there are many public figures that do not like their voices. And I will actually admit that for years, actually, until recently, I have never heard one of my own recordings. My own podcasts, my own meditations, my own hypnosis sessions. Just never cared for my voice. I felt it just sounded weird. But if you think about it, it should. Because what I hear and you hear is different. But as you go on, you realize that's silly. If you have to do something, you just do something. You don't question it and become fearful of it. You do it. In my coaching and therapy session, I urge my clients to carefully consider how they use or misuse their voices. When speaking to loved ones or family and friends, think, please, please, please. Breathe and think before you speak. A part of becoming a civilized adult is that we think and process before we lash out. That whole like, oh, that person, just stop. You sound like an asshole. You will never get anything, as I said, with vinegar. You will get abundance with honey. Your voice is the main connection between you and the world around you. So do you want people to think that you're just an asshole? Because people don't see people as tough. They just see them as either really, really nice or he's an asshole. Your voice can make you seem powerful and confident, or hesitant and weak. Your voice can lift others with passion and energy, or bring them down completely. Your voice can help people feel the emotion that you feel, or leave them feeling cold. You, my friends, have the opportunity to make an impact, but most of us speak without even thinking about how we might sound or how we will make others feel. We're too involved in what we want and how we want it. And again, that whole world that you think revolves around you and your needs have to come first. Wrong. Now, let me share with you some tools. Here's how I describe the tools you have to control your voice. So let's get a little technical about the actual voice itself. My analogy is to an old school stereo system. The power, of the stereo system is your breath. Those knobs control your volume, your pitch, and your tempo. With these three knobs and the power of your voice behind it, you can produce millions of sounds to control your mood, the meaning of your conversation, and the impact of your words. Here are four controls to power up your voice. Number one, control your volume. This is obvious in terms of your loudness or softness. You certainly want to project yourself, I get it, so that people can hear you, and you should. But your volume must be tempered to meet the demands of your space, basically where you are when you're talking, the noise around you, and the distance from the person in front of you that you're trying to speak to. Remember, again, breathe, think, speak. That's a t-shirt. We all know that person who needs to get their point across, they will speak louder and louder than you. And all they are doing is now shouting at you. Too much volume doesn't always convey confidence. It may make them just sound stupid and desperate. We also know other people who have great ideas but speak so quietly that they seem unconfident and are sadly, largely ignored. And they may have the greatest of idea. They're just not loud enough, passionate enough. I know more people like this. Here's another tool that you can keep your voice at regular volume, but you alter your speech. When you play with this pitch button, you can make your voice go very high or very low. High as in high and low as in low. Obviously, we each have our own range and can't necessarily go as high or as low as others. But we can make the best use of our own potential. You can use pitch as a way to not have to scream or yell. Try it. You see, monotone voices. For example, drone on and on and on and make no use of their pitch. Do you know anybody like this that just talks and just really doesn't get their point across and it just really has nothing to say? And then after a while, you find yourself falling asleep because their voice volume and their pitch just doesn't change. Well, there's an easy fix to that. To convey excitement, to get people interested in what you're saying around a particular point, you'll often want to go to the higher end of your range, as in, I love this team. You are the best. While a more serious or somber point would call for you going to the low end of your range, as in, we missed our numbers again this quarter. Or, who ate the last donut? I remember in high school, I had two teachers, Mr. Stack and Mr. DeMeo, and they were back to back. Stack was a very good teacher. He was a history teacher, social studies. But he was so monotone. I loved his class, but I would constantly doze off in the back so easily. And then the very next class was Mr. DeMeo, and this man spoke from his chest. He actually looked like Fred Flintstone. And he had such an impactful, strong voice, but I hated his class. So remember, a lot of what you say is not just how you say it, but more importantly, it's also the content of what you're talking about that keeps people intrigued. Now, this next one I have to deal with recently because I spent some time down south. And the tempo of people's voices fascinates me. I've been to the south many times in my life, but as of recently, I haven't had to really talk to them. And to some, I speak fast. And to many, Melissa speaks extremely fast. But there are some that speak so slow that I stand there wanting to pull the next word out of their mouths. But that is what makes people to me so interesting. Everybody's so different. And they just speak very, very slow. So how fast or slow can you talk? It can be very important, especially when you are trying to get your point out. Talk fast, and this can convey energy and passion. While slowing down can emphasize the seriousness of a conversation or a situation. How about pausing in between words and phrases? Most powerfully of all, a pause can be used to add a dramatic effect or used to add a dramatic effect. See how that works? Now, how about actually taking some time to breathe? The breath is always, always so important. We all do, but I mean while speaking. Practice power breathing. As I said, the true power of your voice emanates from your breath. Consider focusing on your breath throughout the day. Learn to take deeper breaths, slower breaths, through your diaphragm. This is something I focus on during my Monday morning mind's eye meditation. There is a very big difference between my voice here and when I share my meditations. And actually, like I said, slowing your voice down, working on all these different items, especially when you're angry, especially when you're trying to get your point across. Remember, breathe, think, then speak. Breathe, think, then speak. Here's an example for those of you that don't really listen to my Monday morning mind's eye meditation. But I'm going to give you a little teaser. Okay, ready? So, put your hand on your stomach, just below your rib cage, and take a slow, deep breath into where your hand is. Allow yourself more of a belly breath from deep down inside. Allowing yourself to relax. Inhaling and exhaling. Feeling relieved. Feeling at peace. And that was a teaser for my Monday morning mind's eye meditation. As you can see, I changed drastically for that type of session. Try to develop this habit and it will be invaluable to control your voice, especially when anxiety rises. That's when you need it. When you know you're about to yell at your children or your spouse or your family member or someone at work. Think, breathe, then speak. It will save you so much. Just before you speak in that tense situation and you're ready to let go of it all, think, speak, and breathe. Take several of these breaths and be in the moment. Understand that your body's energy is going from 0 to 60, then from 60 to 0, then from 0 to 100, and it's only hurting you. Anger and especially rage will only eat you up. And is it worth it? Think about that. The next time you're about to get into a screaming match with someone, is it worth it? I used to have anger issues. Yes, I did. When I was younger. And I realized one day that the only person that was making feel like shit, it was me. And I would ask myself, why? 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 It's not important. So I can make sure that I get my point across, to make sure that you know that I am right and that you are wrong. It's kind of childish if you think about it. Most of the fights, many of the fights that we have, are just so petty. And it's just such a waste of our own time and mind and space. And how horribly it affects your health. There are so many people walking around with high blood pressure and heart conditions. And trust me, it's not just your heart. It affects your entire body. So, stifling your voice affects your body. Using it incorrectly, powerfully, to get your point across by any means necessary, to yell and scream, affects your body. And as many of you know, the name of this podcast is to reset yourself. You. Yourself. There's a difference between speaking up and just being a loudmouth. And as I said, there's a shame, because I have met so many people that would choose to not speak up at all and not express themselves, and let others know what they're thinking for fear of either being judged or basically just for fear. Don't do this to yourself. Please. You're worth the time. And for you that are working so hard, you're worth the money. And as I also mentioned, when it comes to communication, so many relationships, friendships, marriages end because of a lack of communication, a lack of speaking up and telling the other person what you truly feel and how you feel. Maybe because you don't want to hurt them. Maybe because you feel that what you have to say isn't important. But my friends, I am here to tell you, it is. God, it so is. It may sound silly to you, but it's not. And if it's a true friend or somebody valuable that you're speaking of, even if it's not, they won't make a big deal out of it. If you find yourself sharing your peace today, tomorrow, with someone who's now judging you, not for nothing. Think about the relationship and know your value. I think you're worth it. I think you're worth being around somebody who wants to listen to you. And let me tell you something. If you're around somebody who doesn't, there is somebody out there who wants to hear all of your stories, all of your silliness, all of your jokes. Just because the person that you're with now doesn't mean that there isn't somebody out there that would. There is always somebody out there that would be so fascinated by you and want to share in your life. And most of all, hear your voice. The power of your voice. But remember, too much voice is too much. Should you not speak your piece? Well, this show is more about speaking up. But remember, there is a gigantic difference between speaking up and just being a loud, rude mouth. There really is no reason to have to prove yourself that badly that you get that bothered. And for those of you that can't handle and need to get even angrier, my advice to you, because I've done it, walk away. Walk away. Always think about your health. Remember me right now, the next time you find yourself getting angry. Your health first. You want to be able to have another conversation tomorrow. And you also don't want to hold things in, because that will kill you. It's a balance. It really is. It's a balance of life, of speech, and your passion. Always think about your health and see what it's worth. And here is my biggest tip for keeping myself in check and my blood pressure low. When having a conversation with anyone that you're talking to, you know what? This is probably the biggest lesson. Look at the source. I think it's fascinating that people will have a deep conversation, angry conversation, a passionate conversation with somebody that you know is not even listening to you. Someone that is so convinced of their own opinion, their own beliefs. This especially comes to serious conversations, but especially when it comes to like politics and religion. There are people that are set in their ways. It is their belief for years. And it's nice that you feel that you can come along and try to guide them on a newer path. But the bottom line is, what ends up happening to many people is they push back when you push. I share, I guide, I don't push. I don't try to convince. I don't try to manipulate. I just do some research here and there, and then I share. Because these are the things that made me think. These are the things that made me a better person. And trust me, most of the things that I've learned came from my mistakes. You don't really learn a lot when you do well. You learn more when you don't. And if you hide for that and you ignore those, you're never going to learn. I have no problem saying, I fucked up. And what did I learn? So that I don't do it again. When having a conversation, look at the source. Who is the person in front of you that you are nitpicking with, that you are fighting with, that you are quarreling with? Should you continue the next sentence? I'm not saying to ignore them. You can let them speak their piece. But time is valuable, correct? Your time is valuable, I think. Have you ever found yourself getting into a fight with someone? And realizing that when all is said and done, yes, here you are trying to prove your point, speak your piece, and let this person know where you stand, knowing that they actually don't and probably will never give a rat's ass. Because all they're doing, and this is a big thing with me, ever speak to someone that as you're trying to finish a sentence, they're looking at you, waiting for you to take a breath so that they can immediately jump on and tell you their opinion? Or if you tell them that something good happened to you, something better happened to them, or even weirder, is when something bad happens to you and they need to tell you how whatever happened to you isn't that bad because what happened to them was even worse. I'm always fascinated by those people. It's like, I know actually a lot of people like that. And I always think it's funny because once you get good at it, you can see it in their eyes. It's like they're listening, and then all of a sudden, they have like this nervous twitch or something. And you know that from that moment on, they are not listening. All they are doing now is watching your mouth to see when you take a breath. So they can immediately tell you that, yes, I am very sorry that you have cancer, but my cancer was worse. And oh my God, you had a kitchen fire. That sucks. But my entire house caught fire. You had a bumper, like a little crash? Oh my God, I totaled my car. I totaled it. I don't know why that's something that people need to share that passionately. It's so funny. I usually tend to let people just speak their piece. And if they ask about it, I will tell them. But the last thing I want to do is blow their bubble or steal their moment of glory. If they did well, I will enjoy what they're talking about with them. I will not feel that I need to tell them that I also did the exact same thing. That's petty. And it's, again, stupid. Again, it's about thinking. Well, remember what I said, breathing, thinking, and then speaking, breathing, thinking, and then speaking. This will help you so much in so many different ways, especially when it comes to the professional world. For those of you, as I've said, I've met many people in many jobs that had great ideas. I mean, great ideas. And I would tell them, oh my God, go share them. Go let the others know. And, you know, no one cares. It's stupid. I'm dumb. They're just going to think I'm silly. It's a waste of time. And here's the thing that I always find funny, that within that conversation, it's almost like someone's listening. And within a few weeks, a few months, someone else has stepped up and decided to share what that original person's ideas were. And maybe it wasn't even theirs. They just came up with the same ideas. And that person was immediately put on a stage and glorified and given a raise and given them, you know, a new title, and they're doing so much better. And now the quiet person is pissed. That's fucked up. They stole my idea. Da 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 da. And it's like, but you didn't speak up. What were you afraid of? Of someone actually saying no? I mean, I would rather have somebody say no than just have an idea floating in the air wondering if it's good or not. That, my friends, is a waste of your time. And as I said, your time is valuable. So, again, when speaking to someone, know the source. Look at the person's face. Many are good. Many are bad. And a lot of these people, especially on social media, especially on TikTok, they are very uninformed. Because sadly, there is no true editing. There's not what the police that tell you, the Facebook police. That's nonsense. The truth is, speak your piece, but at least know, do your research. Don't just start, you know, copying what other people are saying and just putting it out there. Because it's so funny how people will write in. I'm one of those people that when I go on social media, I read the comments always because I think they're hilarious. And so many people won't even read or watch the story. They just start commenting because they don't know what's going on. It's just do your research. Become informed before you speak your piece and you go off and start sharing gossip, which is not real, with others. So, before you go get angry at someone for telling you what to do or what not to do, because they're just talking out of their ass, think. Are they worth the time? Are they worth your time to get angry, to get violent, to get pissy? Do you know of anyone in your life right now that chooses to talk out of their asses instead of doing some research? We all do. But remember this. The same way you have a right to speak your piece, so do they. And this really shows on the internet. Remember, when you post something, it stays there for a long time. And it may haunt you, especially in the future when you're going for a job or you're meeting someone, planning on dating someone, and there's things that you don't want that person to know about you. All they have to do is scroll back through the internet, through your history, and see what your opinions were. So please, breathe, speak, think. That was out of order. So use your voice, but please do it, but be aware what may come out. And I hope I made you think, and I hope I made you think about speaking up more and sharing your peace with others and not being too angry. This was another episode of the Reset Yourself 22 podcast. God, I hope I made you think. God, I hope I made you realize that you can be a better person. Always. I could. Every day. Every single day we can be better than we were yesterday. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for listening. I appreciate each and every one of you so much, and I love your comments. And I love the fact that a lot of you share with others. It means the world to me. And actually, for those of you that didn't see, I was going through the statistics for the platform that I use, and I just picked up another new 16,000, I forgot it was 575, new listeners. It's weird the way they set it up. It's like they do it in segments, like every couple of months. So that's very cool. And again, being heard in many countries, which means the world to me. And you mean the world to me. Thank you very, very much for listening. Good night, everyone. Yeah.
achieved by Noema, hypnosis and healing and the mind's eye meditation, and dedicated to all those that get up every day and hustle and do all they can to make a difference in their lives and the lives of others.
Oh my God.
If you are interested in learning more about the services that Jimmy offers, visit www.noemahh.com. Jimmy offers a downloadable ebook and a link to his mind's eye meditation sessions, which are both offered for free. Please consider it a gift. And for those that like the do-it-yourself approach, Jimmy also offers pre-recorded self-hypnosis sessions. If you prefer the one-on-one approach, feel free to reach out. You have been listening to the Reset Yourself 22 podcast.